This beginner-friendly Unreal Engine 5 video tutorial will show you how to easily create this forest lake scene in just a few minutes. Don't worry, it's really easy, and I also recommend downloading a free PDF guide from the link in the description. This way you will have all the information, values and steps from this video in one place for future reference. So let's start. Go File, click New Level and choose Basic. To move around editor, use the left mouse button to move the camera forward and backward, while moving the mouse left and right rotates the camera. For a more immersive experience, hold down the right mouse button and use the W, A, S and D keys to move just like in a FPS game. Go up and down with E and Q keys. Save the level first in case it crashes. Go File, save the current level, name it and hit Save. The next step is creating terrain. Go Landscape Mode or Shift 2. Over here choose the size. I'll go with 63x63. And make sure that this Enable Edit Layers is selected. And location is 000. Click Create and we got our terrain. Let's add our lake. Go to Selection Mode Shift 1. Select and delete the floor. We don't need it. Now go to Edit Plugins. Type in land and over here enable the land mass and water plugin. Restart the engine. To add lake, go add button and type in lake. And just drag and drop this water body lake to your terrain. To increase the size and shape of your lake, just select the spline nodes and move them around. Right click and select Add Spline Point here. Now you can create lake shape. Also, if you select a water body lake in the outliner, you can move the whole lake in the middle of the landscape. I'll show you how to reduce the waves and change the color of the lake and waves later in the video. Let's now add landscape material. Go to Add, select Quixel Bridge. Over here type in forest floor. I already have one downloaded. Just click the green download button and hit the blue button to add it to the project. Go All, Mega Scans, Surfaces. Over here choose your material folder. Now select landscape in the outliner and scroll down to see landscape material. Now drag and drop forest floor material to the landscape material. If I click play, you can see that our floor is a bit tiny. So we need to double click our material and enable tiling. Over here change the value to 0.2 for both X and Y tiling. Now our floor looks better. There is a nice feature of the Unreal Engine that allows you to paint over the landscape to make scene more realistic. Check out this video to learn more about it. Click on the card up here or check out the description for the link. Before we start adding trees and grass, let's make the terrain a little bit bumpier. Go to Landscape Mode. Over here select Sculpt Mode. Adjust Tool Strength and Brush Size and paint around your lake. If you mess something up and make it too much, just select Smooth Tool and smooth things out. Let's now add trees, grass and foliage. To add trees, go to Unreal Marketplace, go Free, go Mega Scans. Over here choose European Home Beam and click Add to the project. After the download is finished, go to your project, go to Foliage Mode. In the content browser, you will have the European Home Beam folder. Go to Foliage, Simple Wind. Now select every second or third asset by holding Ctrl and selecting assets. After you are done, drag it to the foliage. Select all with Ctrl A and make sure that they are enabled by clicking the blue check mark. Now you can paint. Make sure to set up a brush size and paint density to be something like this. Another great option is Align to Normal. This means that if you check it on, the trees will follow the terrain bumps. But if you turn it off, they will be straight up. So let's keep them vertical. Let's paint our landscape around the lake. You can also sculpt the terrain beneath the forest to raise or lower the forest. Okay, we need some grass also to populate the forest floor. Go to Quixel Bridge and go 3D Plants. Go Grass. And I'll choose Wild Grass. Download and import. And if you go to Foliage Mode, you can see your foliage. If you don't see it over here, make sure to drag and drop them to the foliage like you did with trees. Now select all Ctrl A and uncheck them all. And now select only the first grass, hold shift and select the last one, and enable them. Reduce the brush size and make the density to be 0.5. Just paint around the lake. You can always add more bushes or something like that if you want. Let's now reduce the waves and change the color and depth of the lake. To do this, select a water body lake, type in wave, and in the wave source, change to none. We removed big waves and it looks more natural. To change the depth of the lake, go to the channel depth value and play with it. Now let's change the color. When I was looking for this, it was really hard to find. Don't worry, it's easy. Select Water Body Lake and scroll all the way down to the Rendering tab. Over here, double-click the water material to open it up. And in the Properties, scroll down that says Absorption and Scattering. Over here, enable and change the color to your liking. Easy as that. Make sure to save everything. The last thing to do is to add some atmospheric lighting and post-process value. Don't worry, it's very easy to do it. Go to Add and type Post-Process. Just drag Post-Process volume to the level, select it, and type Infinite. And make sure that this infinite extent is selected. This will affect the whole scene, not just the post-process volume itself. After that, go to Exposure and change this min and max to be 0. This will remove eye adaptation and fix exposure. You can play with this if you want, but be sure to make them the same value to avoid auto exposure. Type in lumen, and over here set the lumen scene lighting quality and detail to be 4 or 5. This will increase light quality, but also will consume more resources. Also type in contrast and change it over here. I'll reduce contrast a bit to get a blank and smooth atmosphere. Go to Exponential High Fog and change it to Volumetric to get rid of the blue fog. And now go to Fog Density and add some to make a misty atmosphere. After that, go to Directional Light, scroll down and click Use Temperature. And make it warmer. Type in Bloom. Go to Light Shaft Bloom to add some God Rays. This will add a little cinematic feel. Also press Ctrl L to move light around until you see God Rays. They are a bit strong, so play with the bloom scale to make it softer like this. For lighting, it's important to play around with fog density, bloom effect, the position of the direct light, colors, and contrast. Another quick fix is to type in Foliage Actor. Drag it to your scene. This will reduce the wind of the trees. Also, you can play with the season over here to add some variety to the trees. If you find this tutorial helpful, drop some comments below or subscribe to get notified about a new tutorial every week, and be sure to take it slow, don't worry, and keep learning, because the Unreal Engine is awesome. As always, see you in some other video, bye bye!